Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Hatter Adults. Before I work on the last video of the Persona 5 custom series, I want to continue with one of the projects that I announced early this year along with Bayonetta. In this occasion, the video today is dedicated to the anime Free. For those who don't know what Free is an anime series of sports related to swimming. The anime has 3 seasons, a movie, and another net to be released that will be divided in 2 parts. It is one of my favorite anime related to sports. The story is seriously beautiful with an excellent animation and character design, and above all, landscape that made you want to travel to Japan with a great anxiety. The character that I will be creating in relation to this will be Rin Matsuoka, since he is one of my favorites with a great competitive spirit and a great dedication to swimming. He can be seen as a tough and intimidated guy, but he is a kind person and very sentimental. And as always, I made a concept art which I share on my Instagram to better study every detail of the character. This time I want his face look a bit realistic while preserving the anime touches he has, which will be his dashed lines. I really like recreating characters, but sometimes it is better to give a personal touch to each word so that the originality is not lost. So, without more to say, let's get started! For the base and for the first time on the channel, I will use one of the BTS dolls. In this case, I will use the J-Hope doll. I'm very excited to use one of these since it has the perfect proportions for the character. Although I'm a little concerned since I have never drawn on such a small face. But well, I'll deal with that later. The first thing, as always, will be to remove his head and remove his hair to have a clean canvas. I start to cut the hair from the roots with the small scissors. And then scratch the hair inside with a flat screwdriver. And last, remove them with a pair of hand tweezers. Look at this, there was no glue since the hair was burned, although at first glance they look a lot of ants on my hand. Ew! Now I will take a cloth socket in pure acetone and I'm gonna clean his face. So many doll customizers say that cleaning these faces of these dolls is very difficult and annoying, and it is time to check it out. Oh look, I did it! It seems that the key to remove it quickly is to apply enough pressure with the cloth on the doll's face. And with that, I will remove everything else. Now with paint of the same color as Rin's hair, I will paint the doll's bald head. It is not necessary, but it helps me a lot when it comes to making the width for the dolls. With that, now it's time to do his hair. And as always, I use 100% acrylic yarn to make the hair width. I really like this shape of red, as it is closely resembles Rin's hair tone. With the hair wets ready, I will put the wig cap on the doll's head. If you are new to my channel, you will know that I always do the hair on my dolls like this since it is faster. Now I will be gluing the hair wets from the bottom up, guided me by the lines that I have marked around it. But before I continue, first I made a cut so that the length of his head is already defined. And I continue to glue the wet so that it can fill the entire head of his hair. I take this opportunity to mention to you guys that you can find me now on TikTok and enjoy the short videos that I am uploading there. The link is in the description on this video so you can check them. Returning to the video, I already filmed the entire head of the doll, so it is time to use the scissors and give it some cuts. I lift the hair from the top and I start cutting from the bottom to give a few small cuts to the ends. After that, I begin to mold the hairstyle with his hair already moistened with the help of my fingers and a sculpting tool. It was a bit difficult as I want to get the exact shape as he has it, especially the front as it looks like it was lifted from the roots. And with that, Rin's hairstyle is ready. I must say that I really like the result and every detail. And for an extra protection, I will fix it with a hairspray to the entire area. And voila! I'm very surprised that the anime hairstyle fits the size of this head perfectly. It looks great! Since I want it all to look a bit realistic, I will do the same with his body by blushing the entire torso. And the first thing I will do is sand the area that I will use to work so that it feels softer. And by spraying MSC over the entire torso area, I begin to mark the chest with chalk pastels using the color combination you see in the video. So that the lines of the body are better marked on the surface, it is advisable to use a brush of this size like the one I had on my hand and thus continue to mark the rest. Now with the same brush, I will mark his nipples and try to make them well positioned. With the chest full marked, I will continue marking his back in the same way. And then I will continue with his arms, this time using a big brush. And this is how Rin's body looks. I don't need to pass his legs since he's going to have a swimsuit on. Although I have passed him a little below to give more detail. Off camera, I also blush his hands and feet separately. And now that I did it, they blend a bit with my skin tone. Oh my god! And this is how everything is left on the doll's body, and it really looks wonderful just looking at it. Now with that, let's continue with his face and my favorite part. Okay, as you can see, I already put the doll's head to his body and covered it with a cloth to protect the blush. After passing two layers of MSC, I start to draw the first line on his face, which will be the shape of the eyes. At first I was a little nervous because it is the first time I work in this type of mold, but when I passed the pencil to the surface already, I felt more confident. The idea is that the eyes fit the size of his face and do it correctly, since this head is smaller than the ones I have worked previously. With a small eraser, I remove the excess and give them a better delineation to continue drawing. When doing Rin, I also want to give him a daring smile showing his iconic sharp tip. Okay, it's a bit scary, but don't worry, it will be improved when I put more colors on it. I'm going to give his face a bit more realism passing chalk pastel with the same color combination that I used on his body so that it blends naturally. Okay, I don't know why, but in these shots the pencils didn't want to mark the face, so I used them as a watercolor with the help of a fine brush to help me fill in it with color. It was a bit difficult at first, but when you take the rhythm it becomes easier. With the fill colors already in place, I will continue working with acrylics. To further delineate his teeth, I pay a zigzag line. And I continue to delineate his eyelashes with black paint. I decided to experiment a little and paint his pupils with a little holographic paint, and doing it, it looked so great. I carefully paint the shine in his eyes, and I end up protecting everything with ultra glass varnish, this time without passing to the pupil. And this is how Rin Matsuoka's face looks. In my opinion, I think it fits perfectly to the face of this BTS doll, and it looks great with this result. Now let's see what he looks like with his hair on. And as always, the hair does his magic again. He looks amazing! With that, I'll start making the swimming uniform. To make Rin's uniform, I will use a black cotton fabric, which I already marked the pattern of his jacket and the pattern of his swimsuit. In these shots, as you can see, I had sewn some white ribbons in the middle of the slits as part of the decoration. Thus looking uniting to the rest. And with that, I will continue sewing his jacket. And this is how the base of Rin's jacket looks like, as you can see. I also sew the neck piece and other parts that jackets normally have. Everything looks wonderful, especially the decoration with the ribbon. With that already finished, I did the same with his swimsuit, staying this way. With the bases ready, it is time to make the decoration on each piece. I will first start with the jacket by drawing with a pencil the decoration that it has the shape of an arrowhead. Now I will paint everything with black paint. And with a super fine brush, I will pass paint to further delineate each shape. Staying like this. Next, I will be painting a red line on the edges, very carefully so as not to ruin the decoration. Wow, there are still dents missing, but it is already looking incredible. Now I will continue doing the rest of the decoration, which will be the logo of the Samezuka Academy, which I was drawing with a Posca marker. And on the back with the same marker, I had drawn the writing in Japanese kanji of the school, which will say Samezuka Gakuen. And on camera, I made the decoration of his swimsuit on the back and front. With that, I will continue to decorate everything with a coat of paint. I must say that doing this part felt very satisfactory when I put the paint on it, especially when I was painting the logo, which now that I see it well, it looks like the mouth of a shark. And also, having painted the Japanese writing. I am not very good at writing kanji, and I hope I done it well. Although, I had to recognize some words in Japanese just by seeing the writing and its meaning. With that, I will continue painting his swimsuit, moving on to what I marked with red paint. And as you can see, this is how Rin's swimming uniform looks with all the decoration that I made by hand. To finish with the jacket, I will sew a red zipper on the edge. And this is how it looks. The only bad thing is that I cannot close it, but hey, the idea is that the chest is exposed since that was the original idea. And this is how it looks on the body using another BTS doll as a mannequin. Honestly, every detail looks amazing just by looking at it. And with that, his uniform is made. As a final detail, I taken the liberty of making his goggles using an elastic band and making the shape with hot glue and painting everything with acrylic. And with that, Rin Matsuoka is ready. Make your marks. I'm seriously glad to achieve a face like this with this type of face mold. Honestly, working with one of these BTS dolls for the first time was very interesting. I swear that if I get more, I will make Makoto Tachibana and Haruka Nanase, since they are also my favorite characters from Free besides Rin. Thanks for watching this video, like, comment and subscribe to see more content like this, and tell me in the comments which is your favorite sport anime and why. Now with this video I will start working on the doll of Kasumi Yoshizawa from Persona 5, and if you want to know more you can follow me on Instagram as I always post in photos of my videos and snippets of future projects. So it's all for today guys, my name is Eric and I will see you next time, bye!